home and went through hell and back. And we just want justice for Francis.
Because he...
Police and prosecutors are shocked over the death of this woman. Frances Brazel came forward publicly to report a violent rape. As her alleged attacker is about to face trial, she is now dead. A disturbing case involving a convicted sex offender now takes a tragic twist.
Jack Hayes of Des Moines was scheduled to face a trial that could have put him away for life. He is charged with burglary, kidnapping, and rape. But now, the woman who says he raped her is dead. Frances Brazel came forward to News Channel 8's Jeff Greenwood shortly after this all happened in the fall. Now she's dead, as we say. Jeff, what's it all mean?
Well, Kevin, it's a tragic case for many reasons, and now it's legally precarious. In September, Frances Brazel was hospitalized following a violent rape at her Beaverdale home. Several days later, it was her wish to talk about it and not conceal her identity.
Strangled me and covered my eyes and face with his other hand, and that's when it all began, the rape.
Frances Brazel told us that her best friend's husband broke into her house, choked her nearly to death, and very violently assaulted her over a period of several hours. Police soon arrested Jack Hayes, a convicted sex offender. Hayes, who's now in jail and is defending himself, is scheduled to go on trial in April and faced a possible life sentence. But the case took a turn yesterday afternoon when Brazel's husband found her dead at home.
But because of her age, being only 43, and not having a medical condition that would cause death that we know of right now, that nothing stands out. And also, she was a victim of a brutal rape, an attack, just 4 or 5 months ago. That raises some red flags as well. So not only is it her age, but she was a victim of a brutal attack, which a trial should be coming up very soon. There's a lot of things that we need to consider. Our detectives are working on this. This is an open investigation. And we just want to find out what happened, how she died, and at this point, we don't have reason to believe at this point that a crime has been committed.
Now, Polk County Attorney John Sarcone, I talked to him this afternoon by telephone. He expresses his condolences to the Brazel family. He said, and I'm quoting here, "Our intent is to go forward. We're not giving up," and he's talking about this criminal case. So Kevin and Stacy, a preliminary autopsy shows no signs of foul play. Mr. Hayes is in jail, but they are waiting for results of some toxicology tests, and that could take a few weeks.
But her death obviously does add some complications to the case.
Yeah, it sure does. There's a myriad of legal questions to be answered here. As I mentioned, he's a pro se defendant, so he's defending himself, at least has so far. But there are questions as to what prosecutors can and can't use in the case. There is forensic evidence that prosecutors were able to obtain. There are statements, but again, the question is what can they use, what can't they use? That's going to have to be decided by a judge.
Jeff Greenwood, thanks a lot for that breaking news update.